And now it's time to transform your life in 15 minutes. Here's your host, Pia McAdams.
Good morning, good morning. Welcome to Transform Your Life. My name is Pia. I'm an author. I'm also an accounting professor and a certified life coach, specializing in personal and small business finance and also fitness. This morning we are going to be doing live exercises, each for the mind, the body, and the soul. 5 minutes each is what I meant to say. And I'm so excited to be talking to you today, because today we're going to be talking about the cure, not the cure, tomorrow's the cure, the cancer to self-discipline. So that's what we're focused on today. By the way, before we get started, I want to thank you for taking the time to watch this live broadcast. And also for those of you that are watching the recording, I want to let you know that I appreciate you as well. I tell you, I'm so excited. I'm kind of like discombobulated in my thinking, but I'll talk about that a little later on in the broadcast, and you'll see why I'm like, okay, why is she like all like crazy? There's a reason. It's a good crazy though. But anyway, without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. So again, today we're going to be talking about the cancer to self-discipline. Can you think of, or can you imagine what that is? It's something that you probably do. And matter of fact, give me a second. I'll tell you what it is. I just did it. It's procrastination. Yes, procrastination is the cancer to self-discipline. And what is procrastination? Well, we know what it is, right? It's actually consciously either putting off or starting or completing something that you consciously decided to do, right? So that's what procrastination is. And we do it all the time, right? There's different reasons why we do it. But today I'm going to focus on the chronic procrastinator, right? So I'm going to talk about three groups, okay? So if you are a chronic procrastinator, it means like you just totally keep procrastinating over and over again for just, you know, you don't even realize that you're doing it. But if you're doing it, it's because of three different reasons. So you find yourself, and when you listen, it's going to be these three different groups, and you may find yourself a member of more than one of these groups, all right? All right, so let me just make sure I said it correctly. What we're going to be talking about now is we're going to talk about the chronic procrastinators and why you do it. Now, number one, okay, listen for your membership. Okay, take out your membership card, because you may need to upgrade your membership. Tomorrow we'll talk about how to get rid of the membership, but right now, look at your membership card and see if you have more than one of these categories. All right, so the first one is the fear of failure, okay? The fear of failure. So you're procrastinating because of the fear of failure. Now, if you're in this group, you're successful to a point, right? You're successful to a point. But what it is that you set such high standards for yourself that you're in fear of never reaching them. So what you do is you work below your efforts. You never work to full capacity. Why? Because those standards are set so high for yourself. And therefore, if you don't work at full capacity, then you're not going to fail. All right? So fear of failure, that's the very first group. Now, the second group is the fear of success. Now, this one is a different category. In this one, you actually fear success because it's going to change your total world. You don't want to be seen as different from anyone else, okay? So you want to just be kind of like blend in with the normal crowd. And you know, like for instance, if you have success, now you're going to be catapulted out. You may outgrow things like your marriage, you may outgrow your family, you may outgrow your friends. And so what you do is you limit your performance. And I got to tell you, up until last year, I didn't even know there was such a category. Guess what? I was the number one card carrying member of that particular one. I remember it distinctly. I was attending a seminar last year in March. And it dawned on me, because they were talking about something, and it dawned on me, oh my God, that's me. Like what, you know, the guy was on stage talking, and I was like, oh my God, that's me. I have a fear of success. Like I always thought, I didn't really think it was a fear of failure, because I mean, yeah, I usually set high standards for myself, but you know, I just think I meet them, being honest here, right? But I never thought it was a fear. Seriously, I never thought it was a fear of failure, even though at that time, again, I didn't know it was this category. So I just kind of lumped myself in that particular category. But I, you know, for me, I didn't think I was a fear. I was like, I'm not really afraid. I mean, I just didn't know what it was. And like I said, I was attending a seminar last year, and he mentioned something about the fear of success. I was like, oh my God, like I literally like, it brought goosebumps to me, brought tears to my eyes, because I was like, that's me. I have a fear of success, because I remember like even growing up, I always stood out. I was always different. And when you're different, you don't want to be different. Like, you just want to kind of blend in with everyone else. But when you're different, you know, you feel different. Other people may not see you different, and they may see you different, but it doesn't matter about other people, right? It's how you feel. And I always felt different, and I didn't want to be different. Like, the way I was thinking, the way the things that came to my mind, like, I knew it was different, but I would kind of like shut it off because I just wanted to fit in. And so anyway, so this whole year, like, if you've noticed me, if you've been following me for this whole year, you've noticed a drastic change. And well, that I would say one of the pivotal points was when I realized that I fit into that category, that I had a fear of success. And I had to come into grips with being different. And it's okay to be different. And I know everyone says that, right? But unless you don't, if you don't identify yourself as being in that category, you don't realize that they're talking to you. Now everyone says, oh, you know, if you have kids, you say, it's okay to be different. You want to stand out, blah, 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 right? But if you're that one that's different, you don't hear it the same way as people that are like normal people do, okay? So I just want you to understand that. But anyway, so that is the second, category of procrastination, is if you have a fear of success. Now the third one, this is when you're actually, you're rebelling against authority. Now this one is a little different, okay? So this particular one, if you're a member of this group, the reason why you're putting off doing work is because you don't want to be controlled, all right? You feel that some type of authority figure is controlling you. And usually authority figure might be someone like your boss, or if you're younger, maybe even your parents, maybe you're the one, okay? But your parents, right? And so what you do is you actually procrastinate because it gives you a sense of control. All right, so those are the three categories. Now, do you find yourself a member of one, two, or more of these categories? Let's go again. The first one was the fear of failure, okay? So the fear of failure. The second was the fear of success. And the third one is rebelling authority. Now, all three, no matter what category you put yourself in or identify yourself as, you know, chronic procrastinating is not good because it's hindering you. As a matter of fact, again, that's why it's called, where I called it, the cancer to self-discipline. Keep in mind, this whole month we've been talking about self-discipline. Well, that is a cancer to self-discipline. But guess what? Understanding it, okay, and categorizing yourself into one of those three categories, particularly if you're a chronic procrastinator, understanding it is the first cause, or the first cause to cure the procrastination. Now, tomorrow I'll specifically give you some cures on procrastination, but today I just wanted to talk about what is the procrastination and then why we do it, and then again give the three groups. All right, so again, hopefully this information is was helpful for you, because again, I'm not talking about, like, for instance, if you just kind of put off, you know, every once in a while, you know, like, just, you know, I'm talking about if you're a chronic procrastinator, like, seriously, like, you know, you have something that you really should start, but you can't start, and you just don't know why. And that was me. I just really did not know why I didn't do it. Let me give you the case in point. Like, seriously, this is why I was so excited about this broadcast. It's this thing right here. They just arrived, guys. My book just arrived in the mail yesterday. Came in the mail yesterday. But let me explain to you why this was, you know, this was poignant, this particular broadcast. By the way, if you know this, I actually had the subject lined up even last week, you know, because I kind of do these ahead of time. But with this book right here, guys, I wrote this book 3 years ago. 3 years ago, and it's now coming to fruition. 3 years. Matter of fact, it might be 4 years now, because I think I was saying 3 years last year. Now it's coming to fruition. I was procrastinating on this book. Remember, I told you I fit into that second category, which is the fear of success. That I didn't realize that's why I was procrastinating, because I didn't want to stand out. Well, guess what? As you can see, I've actually like turned in my membership card, because my book is actually coming out. I will talk more about this in another broadcast, and I'll give you information on how you want to get it, or how to get it, and even what it's about. If you've been following me, we actually did feature this book last year on this broadcast, right? But I just want you to see that there is a cure for procrastination, all right? I'm sorry, like, the sun's like coming in right now, but there is a cure to procrastination, and tomorrow we will talk about it. But this was my biggest, this was my pivotal point. This, guys, is one of the lifetime goals for me, because writing the book and getting it published is huge. It was major for me, and guess what? It is now coming to fruition. All right, so anyway, so now we're going to move on to the second portion of the broadcast, and this is where we're going to be doing some... matter of fact, give me a second here. I'm trying to unhook all my wires as I'm talking to you. By the way, happy Thursday. Today is Thursday. And as you can see, it's like bright and sunny. It started a little later this morning. And
because I had an exciting evening last night, and anyway, okay, so make sure, again, sorry about all this terrible lighting here. I want to make sure I have everything. Okay, I think I have everything. Oh, I didn't turn on my lights. There you go. Now you can see me. All right, so how are you guys doing on this lovely Thursday morning? This is a great day to be alive, and hopefully you are approaching it as such. And again, I want to kind of give you a little sense of what we're going to be doing coming up. We're going to be doing some yoga. So particularly, we're going to just be doing a little five-minute segment of yoga. And before we get started, I want you to take your three deep ujjayi breaths. Okay, this is to get yourself centered, ground, and aligned. I then want you to set your intention of what it is that you want to accomplish for this next 5 minutes in the yoga. All right, and while you're doing that, I'm going to go ahead and get the music started. And then go ahead and meet me on the mat. Tabletop position, remember? Before you get started, as you set your intention, you've got yourself centered, ground, and aligned. I want you to go internally and see what's going on at this present moment in your body. You see if there's any strains, any stress, any negativity, any tensions. And I want you to use your breath as we use to go through this next 5 minutes of yoga. Use your breath to be directed toward those tight areas in your body. Okay? So go ahead and take a nice deep breath, inhaling through your nose. And as you exhale, drop your chin down to your chest. I want you to round through your spine, tuck your tailbone under. This is the cat pose. As we inhale, your head and chest is going to come forward. You're going to arch your back. Tailbone sticks out toward the back of the room. This is the cow. Now, as you know, the cat-cow is one of my favorite poses to get started in. It loosens, limbers up the spine, loosens up the core. It just overall feels good. So just kind of use your breath. Again, while you're doing this, go internally, see what's going on inside of your body. Let's draw a breath in one more time. And then this time as we exhale, we're going to curl those toes under. We're going to take it to downward facing dog. And go ahead and start to pedal your legs. Now your fingers and toes are spread out nice and wide. Your middle fingers are facing forward. Thumbs are facing in. Your head is in alignment with your bicep, and you're pressing your chest toward your thighs and your knees. You're also pressing your shoulder blades away from those ears. Now lift the kneecaps to engage those quadriceps. Get a little deeper stretch on those hamstrings. Now as we inhale, we're going to draw the knees down toward the mat. And as you exhale, straighten out the leg. Trying to get those heels down. If you can, don't worry about if you can't. Just again, it's going to depend on your flexibility in those hamstrings. Let's do that again. As we inhale, draw the knees down toward the mat. And as we exhale, extend the legs, pressing your chest toward your thighs and your knees. One more time, as you inhale, draw those knees down in toward the mat. And as you're drawing your knees down to your mat, you're actually getting some pressure on the balls of your feet. Okay, stretching out those toes. And as you exhale, straighten out the legs. All right, now I want you to slowly keep your palms down flat, walk your feet in toward your palms, and if you need to, bend your knees. Once your feet approaches the palms, I want you to slowly round yourself up, taking it one vertebrae at a time, making sure that your head is elasticized. And we come into Tadasana, mountain pose. So your feet are together or slight distance apart. Your head is a natural extension of the spine. Pretend like there's a string attached from the crown of your head, extending all the way up toward the sky. Your chest is lifted, your shoulders are drawn down and back in toward your spine, and fingertips are facing toward the earth. As we inhale, we're going to draw the hands, arms overhead. And as we exhale, we're going to swan dive the body forward. Take your time and use the full breath. As we inhale, we're going to look up halfway, flatten out the back, shoulder blades pressed down away from your ears. As you exhale, we're going to forward fold, place your palms down flat, then step back right, left into the plank. As you continue exhaling, go ahead and release your knees, your chest, and your chin. As we inhale, we're going to take it all the way up to the cobra. Remember, if you need to, you can modify. And as you exhale, we're going to curl those toes under and take it to downward facing dog. Now, on the next breath, as you inhale, we're going to bring that right knee into your chest. And as we exhale, we're going to extend that right leg all the way back. Let's do it again. As we inhale, bring that right knee into your chest. And as we exhale, extend that right leg all the way back. One more time. As you inhale, bring that right knee into your chest. And as you exhale, extend that right leg all the way back. This time, go ahead and bend the knee to open up the hip. Now, you're pressing your chest toward that left thigh and knee. Again, head stays in line with your bicep. Now, go ahead and straighten out that right leg in one swoop. We're going to bring that right foot toward the fingertips. Turn that left foot in perpendicular and take it up to Virabhadrasana, or I should say Warrior One. As we exhale, we're going to take it to Warrior Two. Inhale. Relax your shoulders and exhale. Do that again. Inhale. And exhale. Now go ahead and take the left hand back, right arm goes up and over, and reverse the warrior. Now the tendency on here is to lift up, okay? Keep your hips pressed down, keep that right knee just above the ankle. Now take a nice deep breath, and as you exhale, bring that right arm just above the left knee, or right knee, and take the left arm up and over. Now again, relax the shoulder, lift up your torso so you're not leaning on this right leg. Okay, lift up your torso. All right, go ahead and rotate. Place the palms down flat. Take it back to the plank. Release your knee, chest, chin, or you can chaturanga dandasana. Inhale. And then curl the toes under. And exhale. Couple deep breaths here. Remember, while we're in downward facing dog, you can swing, you can actually pedal your legs. You can move your hips side to side. Remember, just do what feels comfortable for you. This is an active resting position. Now, as you inhale, this time we're going to bring that left knee in toward the chest and extend that left leg all the way back. Do that again. As we inhale, knee comes into the chest. And as we exhale, extend the leg all the way back. Now one more time. Inhale. And exhale. This time, go ahead and bend the knee, open up the hip. And remember, it's not uncommon for one side to be tighter than the other. So be patient and be kind and be gentle with your thoughts. Now go ahead and extend that leg, and in one swoop, bring it up toward the fingertips. Turn that right foot in perpendicular, by the way. The left heel is dissecting the arch of that right foot. You're pressing your hips down toward the mat, making sure your knee is directly over the ankle. Extend the arms overhead. If there's any strain or stress, feel free to modify. Inhale here. And as we exhale, Warrior Two. Inhale. Rotate your torso. And exhale. Nice long extension. Again, inhale. And exhale. Inhale here. Right arm goes down. And exhale. Deep breath again. And as you exhale, remember, use your complete breath. Take your time. Then go ahead and rotate over. Place the palm down flat. Take that leg back. Release your knee, chest, chin, or chaturanga dandasana. And then inhale. Relax the shoulders. And then exhale. Keep your palms down flat. Walk your feet in. This time we're going to forward fold in Uttanasana. So go ahead and take your fingertips and clasp the outer part of your elbows. Let the crown of your body, your head, bring your body weight naturally forward. As you inhale, just kind of hold your position. As you exhale, surrender, release, and relax into the pose. Micro bend on those kneecaps. Engaging those quadriceps, giving a deeper stretch on the hamstrings. All right, go ahead and release the fingertips down toward the mat. And then slowly round it up. Again, take it one vertebrae at a time, making sure that your head is the last to rise. Draw the breath in. And as you exhale, dive the body forward. This time, we're going to place the palms down flat. Walk your feet out, toe heel toward the edge of the mat. As you exhale, release the tailbone down toward the mat. Bring your palms together at the heart center. Bow your head down and extend some gratitude. Then release the palms down. Take them behind you and then slowly start to transition yourself into a comfortable seated position. Facing to the front. Make sure that you're on your sit bones and off the fleshy part of your bottom. Now as we inhale, we're going to take the arms up overhead. And as we exhale, release the fingertips down toward the mat. Sit it again. Draw the breath in. And exhale. One more time, nice deep breath, this time bringing in all of that positive energy. Greet the palms together at the very top. Exhale, bring the palms down to the heart center. And we say, Namaste. All right, thank you for practicing yoga with me. This brings us to the third and final exercise, which is going to be the meditation. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to be doing a 2-minute meditation exercise. This is a breathing exercise. Focusing on meditating, and focusing on your breathing. So what you're going to be doing is you're going to, for the next 2 minutes, you're going to be counting your breath, okay? So breathing as if you normally would. So you're not going to manipulate your breath in any shape, form, or fashion. You're just going to breathe as you normally would. But I want you to count your exhales. Now, as you're counting your exhales, at any time you become distracted by either outside noises or internal noises known as thoughts, I want you to first acknowledge the distraction, then bring your attention back to your breath, continue counting, but restart all over with a count of one. All right, so if you're counting, you get up to number 3, and you recall that there's something that you need to do, you're going to acknowledge what it is that you need to do, then you're going to direct your attention back to your breath, and you're going to start all over with a count of one. And you're going to do this for 2 minutes. Again, I recommend you do this at least one other time today, particularly if you're just a beginner, if you're a beginner meditator, and even if you've been practicing meditating for a while, this is a great exercise. This is a great 2-minute exercise, a 2-minute meditation exercise. All right, so before we get started, we're going to take our 3 deep ujjayi breaths. We're also going to set the intention, and a good intention to have is for you to maintain your focus for the next 2 minutes on your breath. All right, so let's go ahead and take a nice deep breath, inhaling through your nose, and exhaling through your mouth. Do that again, deep breath, inhaling through your nose, and exhaling through your mouth. One more time, nice deep breath, inhaling through your nose. This time as you exhale, go ahead and close your eyes and begin your counting now. Thank you. right, go ahead and release, relax, return, refreshed, and calm. You've done something good for yourself today. Thank you for taking the time to meditate with me, and also thank you for taking the time to watch this live broadcast of Transform Yourself in 15 Minutes. Guys, please share this information with your family and friends. You know, like I always say, I do appreciate you doing that. Now, your word for today is merit. So I want you to have a day filled with merit. And I will see you tomorrow at same time. Bye.